Okay, so this is the body, the blockboard body of the Brian May Red Special, and I'm just going to walk you through the construction of it. I'm about to glue up the bottom, so it's made in two halves. This is the bottom half, and it's constructed of a sheet of 3.6 mil ply with the cutout for the oak insert. We've then got, these are 11 by 44 millimeter pine planed battens, I suppose you call them. So they're cut, and I've picked the best ones that fit with the grooves, and I haven't had to do anything with these. And they are ready for gluing. I'll make sure I put these back in the right order. And there's three pieces down the bottom. I've already glued these three together in one piece, just as a test. I'm using the Gorilla Glue, which seems to be very popular. It's very tough glue. And then the oak insert. So this is a piece of European oak. That's 3/4 inch wide. So that's 19 millimeters by 4 3/4. And this piece is about 15 inches long. And then again, the bottom piece is another piece of 3.6 ply. And the cutout there. So the construction of the body is the oak insert goes in there. Now the oak insert is the backbone of the guitar, so the neck bolts onto here. So this is where, and the tremolo comes on the bottom here. So this is the main strength of the guitar. And then we're going to glue all this up. Put all these pieces in here, like that. The top goes on. Now the total thickness of this whole sandwich is 19 mil, and then I'll make another one of these without the oak core, so that'll be the top half of the guitar, so that's another 19 mil, and then with the glue and the oak veneer, so that's about 0.6 mil, and with the glue, probably about half a mil, this will approach the total thickness of the body, which is going to be 40 millimeters. So let's get and glue this together. Okay, so it's now been 24 hours since I glued this up, so I'm just going to take it all apart and see what's inside. I've got two bags of cement on here. A little bit of water has come out of the bag of sand. I'm just going to let that dry a tiny bit, but yeah, I think that's, it seems to be okay. Right, I'll let that dry and we'll see where we go. Okay, so it's in a bit of a mess at the moment. The bag of sand that I used to weigh the wood down obviously had a bit of water in it, and that has leaked out onto the wood here. And I've got some water leakage. So I'm just going to let that dry out. Hopefully this won't be fine. And then what I'm going to do is put this back under the press and weigh it down again, just overnight again, just to keep it completely flat. But I'm just going to let this water dry out now. Okay, so the base piece has now been glued. I've cut it flush here and we've got the oak insert in, and that's all sanded smooth. So I'm going to put that one aside. And now this is for the top half. So I've already cut some more pieces of pine here. I've arranged them all in the best order, so they're all sitting pretty flush together. This is 11 mil by 44 pine. So I'm going to put those down here, and then we're going to glue these up, clamp it up, weight it down, and then we can start the construction of the body. So let's start the gluing. So it's been 24 hours now, and I'm just going to unclamp all of this and let's see what we've made in here. Put this great big bag of sand. That's really, that's 25 kilos, that's really weighed things down. So just release all the clamps. This is what comes out. It's a piece of blockboard. And that is perfectly smooth and flat. But I do have a problem in that my original bottom piece of blockboard, this going to go at the bottom of the guitar. When I put this on this way, I've got a bit of a rock here. So I'm not sure if you can see on the camera, but there is a tiny, tiny bend in this, a little warp. I get a straight edge. I'll put this on here. Now you can see. Come on, leave yourself alone.